Our technique for solving systems of equations by graphing has some interesting applications to economics, specifically looking at supply and demand. If you graph curves that represent supply and demand, you will see that they intersect at the spot called the break-even point, which is the best spot to set your production levels. Let's begin with some problems here. We'll plot some points, and where they cross will tell us where the best production level is for whatever it is we want to make. In the case of the first problem, that'd be greeny babies. And we see here that our demand curve is 8,000 minus 400x. 8,000 is then your y-intercept. Minus 400x is going to be your slope. If you have trouble drawing the slope, one thing that can speed up this process is to find both intercepts and plot both intercepts. Let's see what happens when y equals 0. If y equals 0, then that means that 0 is equal to 8,000 minus 400x. I can subtract 8,000, then I'll get negative 8,000 is equal to negative 400x. To solve this, I would simply divide by negative 400, and I would get that x is 20. And what this tells me is that this line also crosses the point 20, 0. And so I now know that my line crosses these two points. And it's a good idea to find the intercepts here, because that makes the actual line itself especially easy to draw. We don't have the same ability to do that with 400x, though, with our supply curve, because that crosses the origin, which is only one of our intercepts. In this case, what you'll probably have to do is find some more points to test with. The good news here is that this is not that hard to do. If I plug in 5, y will just equal 400 times 5, which is 2,000. And if I plugged in 10, y would equal 4,000. With a few test points, it's still not that much trouble to actually draw this graph, and we see that if we connect the dots, I now have two straight lines, and incidentally, if you draw this on paper, you really want to use a straight edge wherever you can, because you really want that precision so you can see your solution. In this case, we see that where this crosses is where x equals 10 and y equals 4,000. And so it turns out that we want our price in dollars to be $10, and if that happens, then y is going to be 4,000. The first line, n equals negative 20p plus 1,000, is a good example of one where plotting the intercepts and plotting around that can really save you a lot of work. You can see that I've plotted the y-intercept because when p equals 0, n is 0 plus 1,000, which is 1,000. What we can also do is look to see what p is when n equals 0. If I do that, then I'm going to have 0 equals negative 20p plus 1,000. I can add 20p to both sides. I'll get that 20p is 1,000, and then it works out that p is equal to 50. And that tells me that when p is 50, n is going to be 0. And once again, we draw a straight line through, and we should be all set to go. For my next line, n equals 5p plus 250. This is our supply line. In this case, this intersects at 250. My rise over run is 5. And again, you can try some different test points if you want to. You can try the intercept. It'll work out to be negative, so that might be difficult to graph here. We can try substituting in 90. And I just picked this point arbitrarily. There's nothing special about it. Then n is going to equal 5 times 90 plus 250. That comes out to 450 plus 250, which is equal to 700. And so we then know that our second line is going to cross at about 700 if I substitute in 90. You can try some other points if you wish as well. It is a good idea to find multiple points because the more points you have, the more accurate you know that your graph will be. Let's say I did 150. And again, I'm just picking this arbitrarily. There's nothing special about the number 150. But if I did that, then I would have n equals 5 times 150 plus 250, and this would equal 750 plus 250. And this is what you really want, is to get something that will intersect in a nice place like this one does, because if I substitute in 150, I get exactly 1,000. And now we have something that intersects right along those grid lines, which is what I was hoping for. And again, you really want to use a straight edge here when you can, because now, when I look at the intersection point, they're asking what is the price where those intersect. The price is 30. And so when the price is set to 30, just like this point represents that intersection up there, this point represents the intersection of the supply curve and the demand curve.